Welcome to the Discrete Fourier Transform tutorial. In this video, we'll demonstrate the use of the DFT to transform a sample data into its frequency components and to reconstruct it using the inverse DFT. For our example, we'll use a sample data simulated from ARMA to 1 process. First, type in the DFT function in the formula bar for the F18 cell. Then, click on the FX button on the right of the formula bar. The function argument dialog pops up. Select the cell range of the sample data. Hit F4 and lock the cell range. For the data chronicle order, select 1. For the component, select the frequency component index or step. Reference the cell in E18. Lock the cell for column movement. For the return type, select amplitude or type 1. Now click OK. The amplitude of 0 frequency component is shown. Copy the formula to the cell on the right. Now click on the cell in G18 and click F2 to edit. Click on the FX button to the left of the formula bar. In the function argument, change the return type value to 2 for phase output. The function returns 0 phase for 0 frequency component. Next, select the F18 cell and copy the formula to the rows below it. Select the G18 cell as well and copy the formula to the cells below it. Now, let's plot the spectral density amplitude on a bar diagram. Select the cell starting with the first component. Select a 2D column type diagram. Next, let's reconstruct the time series using a subset of the frequency spectrum. Type IDFT in the formula bar and click on the FX button. IDFT stands for Inverse Discrete Fourier Transform. The function argument dialog pops up. In the amplitude input, select the cell's range with amplitude values starting with component 0. Now lock the cell range. For the phase input, select the cell range of the phase. The number of cells must match the amplitude cell's range. For N, enter the number of observations in the original sample data. The IDFT function returns an array, but since we have 1 cell, only the first cell is displayed. Select all the cells below it. Hit F2. Then press Ctrl, Shift, and Enter together. The rest of the returned array is copied to the selected cells. Note the italic brackets around the formula. This indicates the array return type of the function. Next, let's plot the new time series in the same graph as the original data. The red curve is the filtered time series, or the one we constructed using a subset of the frequency spectrum of the original time series. Let's include more frequency components now. Select the cells in column C. Then press F2. Resize the selected amplitude and phase cell range to include component 6. Again, press Ctrl, Shift, and Enter together to update the cell range. The red curve is updated in the graph. It is following the original signal better. Okay, let's try to add more frequency components. Resize the selected components all the way to 20. Press Ctrl, Shift, and Enter to update the cells. Now the red curve is updated, and it is tracking the original signal very closely. That is it for now. Thank you for watching.